The fourth is plan your journey. Always choose to plan your journey. It's very important for you to schedule your tasks, schedule your everything that you are doing, so that your mind does not have to be occupied by what you must do. Have it written somewhere or have it on your mobile so that you can tick those tasks once they are accomplished, and your mind can be at rest, and so that it can be used only when you need it. My mentor always told me that just as a hammer or a saw is used only when it is needed and it is not carried around all the time, likewise, it is very important for you to use your mind only when you need it and not to carry it around all the time. Well, the mind is all there with you whenever you need it, but you don't have to carry these thoughts in the mind all the time. Put them down on a paper or on your mobile screen, and every time you need to accomplish your task, you can just look at them. You have a ready reckoner. You don't have to necessarily keep them in the mind and keep thinking about it. That way, it creates a lot of clutter. It creates a lot of pressure in your mind. And the fifth one, act on it now. It's very, very important for you to follow up your plan with action. Without action, a plan is worth nothing. Someone told me one day a very wise word. They say that knowledge is power only when it is put into action. Otherwise, simply owning that knowledge is of no use. Share it or use it. Do something so that the knowledge that you have with you is invested and you derive all that you can by using it. So act on all the plans that you create. Make sure that you accomplish your plan. Don't leave your plan unattended, and that way they carry a lot of restless energy that will prevent you from being calm and peaceful. And when restlessness enters the mind, it destroys your peace. The last one is consistency. Always be consistent with your plan. This is very, very important. While you are acting on your plan, make it a consistent affair. Do it every day. That way, your self-confidence will increase. What will also soar as in go high, is your self-worth and self-respect. People also will look up to you when they see that you are accomplishing your plans. And when you accomplish your plans, it shows on you that you are simply the powerhouse of divinity. We have a few more questions. How to differ between false confidence and true confidence? My daughter says that when anyone praises her, she feels very confident. But someone can falsely praise you. How to differentiate? Well, I know this girl. She is a very young girl. She's a small child. But it's a phenomenal question. And she asked last week, but because of the technical glitch, we could not air her question. She's such a cute little girl, but I'm so glad that she's asking this. False confidence, you know, it's such a nicely worded thing that she has used. It is important for us to be confident of ourselves. So when we are confident of ourselves, then we fill this pot of gold. I call self-confidence your pot of gold. You fill that pot of gold. So anyone who appreciates you is welcome, but you don't necessarily need it, right? You don't necessarily need that confidence, need that that appreciation from others. Everybody can appreciate you, but first fill your pot of appreciation yourself. That pot of gold of appreciation will bring about your true self-confidence. But when you get swayed by others' appreciation of you, that is false confidence, which means that when someone appreciates you and you forget everything about yourself, you are living in that appreciation, that is false confidence. But when someone appreciates you and you say, thank you for appreciating me, and then you carry about doing whatever you are doing, that is true self-confidence. So when you have self-confidence, you will definitely appreciate everything that you do. I hope this girl has got the answer to her question. And that was a really light moment for me to have this question from this little girl. And she is not even, I think she is just about 5 years old, and she has got such a deep question with her. Well, thank you very much, all of you, for participating in this live webinar. In fact, we look forward to your participation, your engagement with us. Do communicate with us and let us know how you felt about this webinar, and do let us know how we can help you. We will come with more topics to help your psyche, to help your physiology, to help your overall self. Before I leave, I just want to make this one comment. Your self-confidence, or the lack of it, I would say, is the cause for most of the illnesses that you carry, be it blood pressure, be it diabetes, be it cancers, or any other symptom, including vitiligo, cervical spondylosis, sleeplessness, sleep disorders, snoring, heart problems, kidney problems, eye disorders. All of these have their root in low self-confidence. Make sure that you follow these 6 steps to enhance your self-confidence. And do recommend us, call us, and take the help that you need from us so that you can improve upon yourself. Thank you so much for being a part of this webinar today. We hope you will join us in future webinars too. We conduct many training programs, some of which are free and some of which carry a very small token price, and that is because it serves our administrative costs and also the functioning of our office. So if you are interested, you can write to us asking us about our training programs which help you enhance your potential as a human. We will be glad to assist you in every which way. Thank you so much. Namaste.